So one of the challenges of growing grapes in the Midwest, especially in areas where there's a lot of corn and soybean production, is the potential for herbicide drift. And some of the herbicides that are used in corn and soybean production are growth regulator herbicides. And those are volatile compounds that can vaporize off of a farm field after application or during application and drift for great distances, miles in fact. And so grapes are about 1,000 times more sensitive than other plants, and so they're very likely to be damaged by those compounds if in fact they drift into the vineyard at the appropriate time of the year. And some years the grapes grow out of it okay, but in others they don't. And this is a good example year where they got hit so badly that they're not growing out of it. And one of the real problems we see, the event occurred this year before bloom, before fruit set. And whenever that happens, then the response of the grapevine to that growth regulator is that they fail to flower normally and to set fruit. So we end up with clusters where we have a lot of these shot berries. These little berries are never going to develop into a full berry. One of the problems with drift is that for a grape grower or a tomato grower, there's really no recourse. There's nothing you can do to get your plants to regrow normally or to reset fruit. It's a one-time deal, and there's nothing we can do to avoid damage. We're just basically at the mercy of the weather and the commercial applicators or row crop farmers. So we've established the DriftWatch website, which is a site where growers that grow sensitive crops like grapes or tomatoes or have an organic farm or beekeepers or even state officials that are responsible for sensitive habitats can post on this website their location. The applicator industry then can go online before they make an application if it's in an adjacent field and see if there's a crop that's sensitive to what they might be applying, and there's fact sheets that help them make wise decisions.